Namaskar. Welcome to the course of Introduction to Microorganisms. I'm Dr. Anup Markande. We are continuing with our module on bacteriology. We have just finished introduction, size, shape, bacterial cell appendages, bacterial growth, prokaryotic or bacterial reproduction, and finally we have arrived at domain bacteria. Here we are going to introduce the bacteria and their domain as a whole. What are the kinds of bacteria that are involved in this domain, and how are they classified, and what are their main characteristics? We have already discussed about the three domain classification of living system. This is the phylogenetic tree of life. In this, bacteria, archaea, and eukarya are classified on the basis of their genetic material, mainly the 16S rDNA or 18S rDNA, that is conserved ribosomal rDNA. In this, we came to know that there is a last universal common ancestor, which is the progenitor for the whole living system on Earth. In this module, in this particular chapter, we are going to discuss different sections of bacteria or the domain eubacteria. Domain eubacteria also has one of the major branches is proteobacteria. This includes most of the gram-negative bacteria. These are phylogeny based on rRNA analysis. They have a common photosynthetic ancestor, but few are still photosynthetic. These are named according to the mythical Greek god Proteus. They are the largest taxonomic group of bacteria, and most of these classes designated by Greek letters. So, among proteobacteria, the first one comes alpha proteobacteria, that is the first one. This is known to grow at low nutrient levels. Some are known to have unusual morphology, while many are agriculturally important, while some are medically important genera. As you can see in this tree, most of the organisms cause diseases in humans. Some are obligate intracellular parasites, while others are living in insects. Those which are obligate intracellular parasites include rickettsia, Ehrlichia, Brucella, and Bartonella, while those which live in insects that include Wolbachia and with prosthicae Colobacter, or in among those when they are chemoautotrophic, they are either Natrobacter or Agrobacterium, Acetobacter, Rhizobium, and Azospirillum. Most of these, this particular section of the alpha proteobacteria are nitrogen cycle related organisms, while Natrobacter, Agrobacterium, Acetobacter, Rhizobium, and Azospirillum are used in agriculturally important as biofertilizers. Brucella, Bartonella, Rickettsia, and Ehrlichia are known to be medically important genera causing diseases, as seen here, causes spotted fevers, while others are environmentally important because Wolbachia and other organisms are important in nature. Among alpha proteobacteria, there are human pathogens like Bartonella, which is a bacillus, a rod-shaped bacterium. It causes cat scratch disease. Obligate intracellular parasite, Rickettsia, is a bacillus or coccobacillus in nature. It is an arthropod-borne disease-causing agent, causes spotted fever, rickettsia typhi and rickettsia rickettsii are well-known organisms among these. We will discuss about rickettsia in the later chapters. Organisms having prostheae, Colobacter, we have discussed about these in our previous section where we were discussing about stalked bacteria. These include prostheae containing organisms like Colobacter and hyphomicrobium. Pelagibacter is one of the most important organism known right now because it is one of the smallest genome containing organism, while it is also most abundant marine microbe. Now we are coming to nitrogen fixing bacteria, which include Azospirillum and Rhizobia. Azospirillum is known to be an associated bacteria that is associated with grasses and sugarcane, where it is present on the root and they are fixing nitrogen, atmospheric nitrogen, while Rhizobium and Bradyrhizobium, they are known to form nodules in the roots, especially of the legume plants. These bacteria, mainly the nodule forming bacteria, they enter the root and form nodules, and hence there they help the plant in gaining the nitrogen that is being fixed from atmosphere by these microorganisms. In return, the plant gives them nutrients. It is a symbiotic relationship. Nitrifying bacteria, which includes Nitrosomonas and Nitrobacter, depends on whether the organism is nitrifying or denitrifying. These are all chemoautotrophs in nature. Plant pathogens like Agrobacterium. This is known to insert a Thai plasmid or tumor induction plasmid into the plant cells, inducing tumors. These tumors are known as crown gall. As it can be seen in the image, it is the crown gall on gall disease on the tomato plant. We are using these Agrobacterium tumefaciens plasmids, that is mainly Thai plasmids, in transferring the required gene into the plant in the biotechnology. And hence, this organism is extremely important for gene transfer into the plants. Those organisms which produce acetic acid from ethyl alcohol, Acetobacter and Gluconobacter. These two organisms are industrially important for production of acetic acid and vinegar. Wolbachia. It is one of the important organism involved in insect. These are most common infectious bacteria, but these are endosymbionts of insects and other animals. Endosymbionts, they are living inside the insects and they are living in a mutualistic way of life. As can be seen in this image, these Wolbachia are directly influencing the mating type of the insects. If the Wolbachia is not present in the females, there is no offspring. If they are present in females, offspring is seen. Hence, the presence of Wolbachia in females directly influences the offspring formation, and also if none of the mating partners have Wolbachia, that also is naturally offspring producing pair. Now we are coming to the beta proteobacteria, continuing with the proteobacteria group. These organisms utilize nutrients diffusing from areas of decomposing organic matter. These are known to be hydrogen gas, ammonia and methane produces or utilizes, depending on the where they are and what they are doing. Beta proteobacteria oxidize. If they oxidize sulfur, example is thiobacillus. If they form sheath, an extra layer on the bacterial surface, Ferrotilus. If they do not have sheath, example a usual cocci like Neisseria, which causes disease like gonorrhea. If they are not cocci, if they are helical, Spirillum. If they are rod with polar flagellum, Burkholderia or Zooglea. Or if they cause pertussis, they are Bordetella. While Neisseria and Bordetella are known to be disease causing important, medically important organisms, Zooglea and Burkholderia are known to be important environmentally. Thiobacillus is a chemoautotroph which oxidizes sulfur from H2S to sulfuric acid, and this organism is used for microbial influenced metal recovery, which helps us humans in recovering metals from their ores without extra chemical wastage. These ores are either in the form of copper sulfate, silver sulfate, or many other sulfates and sulfuric acid based compounds, in which the thiobacillus is known to remove the sulfate and remove the metal ion, making the metal more pure, easy to be harvested by human beings. Next comes Ferrotilus. It contains a hollow sheath. It has a polar flagellum, that is one of the important factors in this organism. Although it has a hollow sheath, in that the flagellated organism is present. This is one of the major problems in sewage, where they are growing and they are blocking all the pores of the sewage channels. Spirillum. We have discussed about Spirillum in the major types of bacteria present. In this image, as can be seen, they are spiral organisms. They are extremely large. They are known to be 0.5 to 500 micrometers in length. While normal bacteria like E. coli is known to be 0.5 to 1 micrometer in length. Large, these are extremely large, aerobic freshwater bacteria. Now we are coming to Neisseria. Neisseria is one of the major disease causing agent. Neisseria meningitis and Neisseria gonorrhea, both of them are causing diseases in human beings. Bordetella is an aerobic rod. Sometimes it may also be a cocobacilli, depending on the species. While Bordetella pertussis is known to be causing whooping cough. Now we are shifting to gamma proteobacteria. These are the largest subgroup among the proteobacteria. They have greatest variety of physiological types and includes the Enterobacteriaceae, or the bacteria which inhabit human and other mammal guts. Gamma proteobacteria, it includes Bagiatowa, purple sulfur bacteria, if they are using autotrophic mode of nutrition. If they are chemoautotrophs and use H2S as energy source, they are usually Bagiatowa. If they are using light as energy source, they are purple sulfur bacteria. Chemoheterotrophic bacteria include Legionelles, while if they are growing with common laboratory media, Francisella, or if they do not need special medium, that include Vibrio, Pseudomonas, and other Enterobacteriales and Pastoralelles. Bacteriotuba. It's a chemoautotroph which oxidizes sulfuric H2S to sulfur. It shows gliding motility. Bacteriotuba alba is the only species known in this group. Azotobacter and Azomonas, as the name says, they both are related to nitrogen. Both are nitrogen fixing, free living soil bacteria. Their structure is large and ovoid with a heavy capsule. Francisella. Francisella is a pleomorphic organism. Pleomorphic means it does not have a definite shape. It is without a definite shape. Francisella tularensis causes tularemia, that is rabbit fever, and this is known to be resistant to many known antibiotics. Next comes formerly known superbug Pseudomonas. Pseudomonas are aerobic rods with polar flagella. Pseudomonas, also known as pseudomonads, are containing extracellular, sometimes intracellular, fluorescent pigments. They are opportunistic pathogens known to be causing many diseases in human beings. They are known to be metabolize wide variety of substrates, because of which they were also called as the superbugs, where they could degrade different kinds of aromatic and aliphatic hydrocarbons during the oil spills. They are also known to be resistant to many antimicrobials. They are able to denitrify in nature. Next comes Legionella. They are found in streams, warm water pipes, and cooling towers. Legionella pneumonophila. It causes a form of pneumonia called legionellosis. It can survive inside aquatic amoeba, and hence it is an intracellular pathogen. Coxiella. Coxiella burnetii, it is known for causing Q fever. It is an obligate intracellular pathogen. It is transmitted via aerosol or by milk. It forms resistant spore-like body. It is widely argued that whether the pasteurization method was actually devised by Louis Pasteur to kill Coxiella burnetii from milk. Vibrio. It is a facultative anaerobic coma-shaped bacterium. Vibrio cholerae, it causes cholera, a kind of dysentery. Vibrio parahemolyticus causes less severe gastroenteritis. It is caused due to undercooked shellfish. Vibrio is a known aquatic microbe. Pasteurella. The species of Pasteurella are pathogens of domestic animals. They are known to cause pneumonia and septicemia. They are passed to humans from cats and dog bites. P. maltosida is carried by Komodo dragon's saliva, which is extremely toxic if is in touch with any human beings. Haemophilus. Haemophilus inhabits mucous membranes of upper respiratory tract of human beings. It is present in mouth, vagina, and intestinal tract. It requires heme fraction, also known as X factor, and NAD cofactor, also known as V factor, for its survival. H. ducreyi, it causes chancroid disease, NSTD, or a sexually transmitted disease. Haemophilus influenzae, it causes meningitis, pneumonia, bronchitis, septic arthritis, and erysipelas. Haemophilus is also the organism which was first to be sequenced. The genome of Haemophilus was the first genome to be sequenced by us. Enterobacteriales or enterix. These are facultatively anaerobic rods, that means they need little bit of air. They are containing peritrachous flagellum. They are known to be mostly fermenting and ferment glucose to other sugars, glucose and other sugars. All of these are known to inhabit intestinal tract of animals like human beings. Enterics include coliforms. Coliforms are major indicators for fetal contamination, because if coliforms are found in nature, that means there is some fecal contamination in nature. UTI and traveler's diarrhea is usually caused by Escherichia or E. coli. E. coli 0157H7 is known to be a food poisoning pathogen. Salmonella. Salmonella enterica is one of the major pathogens of enteritis, and it has 2400 serovars. While Salmonella typhi or Salmonella enterica serovars typhi is known to be the causative agent of typhoid fever. Continuing with enterics, Shigella, it causes shigellosis, a bacillary dysentery. Klebsiella, Klebsiella pneumoniae, which causes serious form of pneumonia. While some species of Klebsiella are known to be nitrogen fixers. Yersinia, Yersinia pestis is the causative agent of plague or black death. Proteus, Proteus vulgaris and Proteus are well known UTI and wound infection pathogens. Proteus are also well known for their swarming motility. As seen in this image, the growth of the colony is in the center, while the newly formed bacteria are swarming away from the central colony. Hence, this is the swarming motility, where the bacteria are moving away on the agar. Delta proteobacterium. Here, some species are predators on other bacteria. These are also important contributors for this sulfur cycle. Disulfovibrio is a major sulfur cycle organism, which is helpful in oxidation reduction of sulfur in the metal mines. While aerobes like Dello Vibrio are bacterial pathogens. Micrococcus is a well-known gliding motility containing organism. As can be seen in this image, Dello vibrio, a free Dello vibrio will enter E. coli. This is an E. coli cell. It enters the E. coli cell and starts to divide within the E. coli by eating the insides of the E. coli. And once the E. coli has been infected with Dello vibrio, the cell loses its shape and soon the bacteria are coming out of the E. coli, lysed E. coli cell. Hence, it is a place where bacteria are dividing. Dello vibrio is an aerobic rod with polar flagellum. They are known to attack other gram-negative bacteria similar to the way a virus would. Disulfovibrio, it is a human intestinal tract and anaerobic sediments. It's an obligate anaerobe. It is a sulfur reducing bacteria. We can use sulfur. It can use sulfur for as final electron acceptor, while it can release tons of H2S annually. Myxococcus, we are going to study again among the fungi. They are known to be gliding motile organisms. They feed on bacteria that they encounter. Their cells aggregate to form fruiting body loaded with myxospores. Epsilon proteobacteria. These are microaerophilic, helical or vibrioid rods, motile by means of flagellum. With polar flagellum, you can see Campylobacter. With peritrachous flagellum, you can see Helicobacter. Campylobacter, Campylobacter fetus, and Campylobacter jejuni are both major pathogens. While fetus causes abortions, jejuni causes diarrhea. Helicobacter. Helicobacter is a well-known common causative agent for stomach ulcers. We have discussed till now some of the major parts of domain bacteria or domain eubacteria. As known, the bacterial classification is a complex phenomenon. It is governed by Burgess manual or a book which is governed by Burgess committee. They classify bacteria routinely into different classifications and they decide what bacteria falls in which class or which group, and hence the newly identified organisms can be reclassified on the basis of their presence or absence or their nearest similarity with the already known organism. With this, we are ending the first part of domain bacteria section. Next, we are going to continue with domain bacteria, titled Domain Bacteria 1.